Minnesota Office of the State Auditor. The Fire Form, completing the financial information and pension payments tabs. Hello, my name is Ryan Sendelbach, and I am a pension analyst with the Office of the State Auditor's Pension Division. Today's training session will focus on completing the financial information, other items, and pension payments tabs of the Fire Form. First, before we can begin completing the form, you'll need to gather some materials. Here are the items you will need. First, you will need bank statements for the special and general funds for the reporting year. Next, you will need a copy of your current relief association bylaws. If you paid out a service pension or benefit during the year, you will need the payment information. And finally, you will need a copy of the prior year reporting forms to use as a reference guide. You can obtain a copy of the FIRE form on the OSA website using the State Auditor Form Entry System, or SAFES, which is found under the Forms menu option. The Financial Information tab asks for information about your Relief Association's revenues and expenses. All of the amounts should be as of December 31st of the reporting year. The beginning net asset values should be pre-populated on your form. Confirm that the amounts are correct by checking the ending balance of the prior year's reporting form and your bank and investment statements. Next, enter the amount of FIRE state aid and supplemental state aid that your Relief Association received in this row. Round the amount to the nearest dollar. If your Relief Association did not receive its state aid during the year, enter the amount that should have been received in this row and also list it as an accounts receivable in Section F towards the bottom of the page. Frostbite Falls received $57,826 in FIRE state aid and supplemental state aid, so I will enter that amount here. Do the same with supplemental benefit reimbursements and municipal contributions. If reimbursements or contributions were required or expected to be received but were not, enter the amount that should have been received here as well as list it as an accounts receivable in Section F. The municipal contributions listed in this section must be equal to at least the required municipal contribution as listed on the prior year's schedule form, if there was one. For example, if the prior year's schedule form listed a $1,000 required contribution, there must be at least $1,000 in municipal contribution income listed in this line. If the whole required contribution amount was not received, enter the remaining amount owed to the Relief Association as an accounts receivable in Section F. For example, if the municipality only paid $300 when $1,000 was required to be paid, list the entire $1,000 as income on the municipal contribution line, and then list the remaining $700 as an accounts receivable. Continuing down the page, enter amounts for the investment income that your Relief Association received during the year. Enter the information for both your special and general fund. If you received any income from outside donations, such as from members of the public or businesses in your community, enter the amounts by clicking the Click Here to Enter Outside Donations or Click Here to Enter Other Income links. By clicking the form, will open up the Other Items tab of the form. Under the column Other Items Type, select the dropdown that corresponds to the type of income or expenditure you are entering. To the right, descriptions must be provided for any entries on this page. Then enter the dollar amounts in the appropriate fund column. To return to the financial information page, click the tab at the bottom of the page. To complete the benefit expenditures section, refer to the payment information that you gathered before we began. If the Relief Association paid any service pensions, survivor benefits, or disability benefits during the year, enter the totals here. Detailed information about the payments will be reported in the Pension Payments tab of the FIRE form. Next, the administrative expenditures require you to enter amounts for any administrative expenses paid during the year. If you paid administrative expenses that do not match any of the categories listed, click the Click Here to Enter Other Expenditures link and enter them just as you did for other outside donations and other income. Don't forget to include a description. Back on the Financial Information tab, we have reached Section D, Transfers. If your relief association made any transfers from the general to the special fund during the year, report them here. Transfers can only be made from the general fund to the special fund. The entry in the general fund should be a negative number, and the entry in the special fund should be a positive number. Section E will automatically calculate the total net assets as of the end of the reporting year. Be sure to verify that the treasurer's bond amount that you entered into the plan information tab is at least 10% of the special fund total net asset amount. Relief association treasurers are required to be bonded for at least 10% of a relief association's assets. Scroll down to Section F. Enter any amounts that were owed to your relief association at the year end that were not received until after December 31st of the reporting year in the accounts receivable row. For example, if your relief association did not receive its fire state aid or supplemental state aid from the city until January, the aid would be in accounts receivable as of December 31st. Supplemental benefit reimbursements are another example of amounts that may be due to your relief association but not yet received at year end and should be reported as accounts receivable. Enter any other assets, such as prepaid expenses, net fixed assets, or inventory, here in the Other Assets row. If your relief association owed any amounts to vendors or had any outstanding benefit amounts payable at year-end, enter them here in the Accounts Payable or Other Liabilities row. For example, if your relief association wrote a check to its auditor at the end of the year, but the check was not cashed until the beginning of January, enter the amount as an Accounts Payable. For lump sum plans, the accrued liability will be based on your schedule form. The number may be adjusted for any benefit payments that were made after your schedule form for the year was completed. For example, if a member is paid after the schedule form is completed, the accrued liability on the fire form should be equal to the accrued liability on the schedule form minus the liability for the member that was paid. After you've completed this section, check the Investments tab and Financial Information tab to make sure that the year-end figures tie with one another. To check this, take the total investments at the bottom of the Investments tab, add any accounts receivable, interest or dividends receivable, and other assets from Section F of the Financial Information tab, and subtract any accounts payable. This number must equal the total net assets at December 31st shown in Section E. If the numbers do not tie, a red error message will be displayed, and the discrepancy will need to be corrected before the form can be submitted. The last tab we will complete in this session is the Pension Payments tab. In this tab, you are required to provide detail on any lump sum benefits that were paid during the year. For each member who has paid a lump sum benefit, enter the requested information into the cells. Keep in mind that you can scroll over the red triangles for more information about any particular column. Review your relief association's bylaws to determine the appropriate service requirements and vesting percentages. For example, in 2015, Frostbite Falls paid two service pensions, one for John Doe, a deferred partially vested member, and one for Jane Doe, who passed away and is receiving a survivor benefit. Looking at Frostbite Falls' fictional payment records, I can see that John Doe was paid a regular service pension in the amount of $30,000. John also received an additional $32,366 in deferred interest while he was on the deferred pension roll, in accordance with the Relief Association's bylaws. John also received a supplemental benefit equal to 10% of his regular retirement benefit, up to $1,000. This brings John's total payment to $63,366. Looking at Frostbite Falls' fictional member information, I can see that John's birth date is January 1st of 1965. And his fire department entry date is January 1st of 1985. I can also see that John separated from the department on January 1st of 2000 with 0 leaves of absence, which would give him 15 years of service. After consulting the bylaws at the time of John's separation, I can see that 15 years of service corresponds to an 80% vesting rate. I can also see that the benefit level in effect when John separated was $2,500 per year of service. At the time of John's separation, the bylaws also stipulated that deferred members were to receive straight 5% interest for each full calendar year of deferral. Moving on to Jane's payment, Jane Doe unfortunately passed away, and as such, her spouse received a survivor benefit. Please note that although Jane's survivor benefit is being paid to her spouse, it is still Jane's member information that should be recorded on the fire form. The payment records show that Jane's survivor benefit amount was $75,000 and that there was $0 in deferred interest. Because it was a survivor benefit, Jane's spouse was also entitled to a survivor supplemental benefit, which is equal to 20% of the survivor benefit amount, up to $2,000. This brings the total payment up to $77,000. Looking at our fictional member information again, I can see that Jane was born on January 1st of 1980 and joined the department on January 1st of 2000. She passed away on January 1st of 2015, and as such, that was her separation date. Jane never had any leaves of absence, which means she had 15 total years of service. Because it was a survivor benefit, Jane's vesting percentage is 100%. Finally, from the bylaws, we can see that Frostbite Falls increased their benefit level to $5,000 per year of service in 2015. If any of the members paid by your relief association in a given year had previously separated and then returned to service, please select Yes under the Return to Service column. Fill in all of your relief association's benefit payments. Once you have finished, make sure that the total benefit amount on the bottom of the pension payments tab matches the total benefit expenditures amount on the financial information tab. Once this is completed, you will have successfully completed the financial information, other items, and pension payments tab of the fire form. Next, we will work on completing the cash flows tab of the fire form. See our training video on this tab for more information. If you have any questions, you may contact us by email at pension@osa.state.mn.us or by phone at 651-282-6110. For more information, I encourage you to visit our website to watch other online training sessions, to read our monthly pension newsletter and weekly e-updates, and to review informational documents like statements of position. Thank you.